Hey, Panini, don't you be a meanie. Thought you wanted me to go, or why you trying to keep me teeny?
Hey guys, what's up, Vito? It's your boy Cameron, aka Wayne, aka MBG1, aka Double D, back at it again with a video. And today, as you can see by the title, this is part two on how I got curved, you know. Sorry. All good. But, yeah, so this story happened in the same time the Catherine situation happened. If you haven't watched the Catherine video, I advise you to go watch that video first and then come back to this video. The link is in the description. Go watch that and then come to this one. So, back in sixth grade, it was another girl named Shalonda. I'm talking about everybody, all the boys like Shalonda. I know y'all got, like, everybody got this one girl that everybody just like for some reason, like, you know, so that's basically who Shalonda was. Like I said, we gonna name her Shalonda because you know, can't reveal identity out here, you know. Anyway, so Shalonda went to our school during sixth grade, so everybody, all the boys liked her because of her, you know,
physical appearance.
I wasn't about all that, you know. I was a great sixth grader. I wasn't that wasn't interested in all that, you know. Yeah.
Why the fuck you lying? Why you always lying? Oh my god. Stop fucking lying.
Anyway, so Shalonda had a boyfriend and
Whoa there, buddy.
And yeah, sixth grade. They were off and on. And in the sixth grade, as 11-year-olds, off and on. Yeah. At the beginning of sixth grade. You just hate to see it, don't you? You just hate to see it. So anyway, so even though they were off and on, Shalonda, you know, she kinda talked to other dudes while they were off and on, and Eric, her quote unquote, we're gonna name Eric, or we're kinda, you know, they were talking to other people while off and on. So Shalonda, I was going to lunch one day, and you know, during sixth grade, I wasn't that quote unquote popular, or you know, and I don't like being being popular, or whatever you want to call it, but everybody knows Shalonda. And Shalonda, we were heading to lunch, and she was by my friend Madison, and Madison introduced me to Shalonda, like, personally. And so me and Shalonda at lunch, she was like, hey Dwayne, you know, she didn't want one of those. I was like, whoa, what do I do here? It's like, what do I do? Because I'm talking about, she hit me with it. Hey Dwayne, like, whoa, like, hold on now, like, Nani, help me please.
Nani?
Like, huh? Like, so then, you know, I was like, what it do, baby? Yeah, you know, hit with it.
What it do, baby?
Yeah. Kawhi, you know, let me stop. I ain't say that. I was like, what's up? You know, and it just kept it going, you know. And then she just started laughing at me, like, out of nowhere. So she's just laughing. She's like, so she's looking at me. She's like, just laughing. I'm like, what are y'all laughing at? And they're like, yo, nothing. And I just move along about my day, you know. So, yeah. So fast forward about a week after that, she asked me on Snapchat, and when she added me on Snapchat, she messaged like, hey. I was like, hey, what's up? She's like, what you doing? And I was like, nothing. I'm like, oh, I said, what about you? She said, nothing either, just chilling. Boy, I was like, oh, me too, you know, I'm just on the game, you know, just chilling. He's like, oh, all you boys are the same. All y'all do is play the game. Like,
who asked you? Did nobody ask you about what we do? Okay, I'm gonna need you to mind your business, lady. Don't be coming at us like that. Yeah. Chill out. You know what you got going on with yourself. Anyways,
So anyways, you know, we just texting or whatever. And so, Madison's birthday was like 2 days. It was like on a Friday though. So, I mean, Madison's birthday, she had a birthday party at a hotel on a Saturday, I think it was. And Shalon had added me like on a Friday or something like that. So she went to Madison's birthday party Saturday. And while it was there, it was like late at night. And I was on the game with my folks, you know. It was just cooling on the game, whatever. And I told them what happened. And it was like, okay. You know, we gonna help y'all. You know, we gonna help y'all. You know, we got you, my boy. I was like, all right, bet. So they was like, hey, go ahead, text her. Go ahead, get the conversation started. So I tell her, like, what up? She's like, what up? She's like, what's up? You know, not much, you know, just chilling. I said, you enjoy yourself at the little party? She was like, yeah, you know, I'm having fun or whatever. So, we ended up, we was talking about something. Then my friends were like, hey, should y'all texting? You might as well call the girl. And I was like,
huh?
Come again. And it was like, call the girl? And I was like, huh? Like, me call her? Me call her? So anyways, I ended up calling her and she answered the phone and it was like, hey. And I was like, hey. So then we were talking about, you know, we were just chilling. My friend was just laughing in the background. And I'm trying not to laugh. She just looking at me like, wait, what you laughing? I'm like, nah, you know. Because my friend's just dying in the background. Because I'm like, I don't know what to say. So then, you know, her
Wi-Fi at that hotel was garbo. Because every time that I would talk, it would be like a 5-second delay. And I would hear myself like 5 seconds later on her phone. And it was like, huh?
So yeah, that was out the window. But anyway, so I sent my picture friend of her. I sent my friends a picture of her. And they were like, hey, you gotta compliment her, whatever. And then so I was like, alright, bet. So, you know, so I said, I took my phone, you know, I got my phone right here, you know. You know, I opened the phone, you know, went to my little keyboard and I typed in. This is what I typed in. I said, I like your shirt. And I just sent it.
Really, nigga?
And when I tell y'all, my friend said, did you actually just send that? And I was like, yeah. And I was like, are you dumb? So, I just told this girl I liked her shirt. Instead of being like, nah, I was just like, you know, you look good in that shirt, you know? Or something like that. Something stupid. I don't know. But like, we gotta think about it. At the time, I was unexperienced. I didn't know what I was doing. I didn't know. I didn't know what to do. I was nervous. I was like, please help me, Lord. Please get me out of this predicament. Because I think I just said that wrong. But you know what I meant. Get me out of this. Help me, please. Help me. So, I'm talking about these folks dying in a party. And these folks, and to this day, these folks still say, I like your shirt. To the, like, oh, we gotta bring up these bad memories. So, anyway, she was like, oh, thank you. And I don't think she actually meant that thank you. But we just gonna roll with it. We gonna roll with it, you know. We gonna roll with it. So, fast forward about an hour or two, you know, we still texting or whatever. During that conversation, we were talking about some stupid stuff. But one thing I can vividly remember was she said, I want a milkshake. And I was like, you know, in my head in sixth grade, you know, I was like, you know, be like,
you can have some of my milkshake.
All right, I'm a fault with you.
All right, bro.
You know, you can have some of my milkshake. I said that.
What the? Why are y'all calling me? What the freak? Sorry for that. It's 5:42 a.m. What the heck? So, like I said, you can have some of my milkshake. Something like something stupid like that. And she was like, boy, just stop. So then eventually I asked her the question, because we've been talking for like a good 2 weeks now. I asked her like, bro, you trying to be my girlfriend now? What's up with it? And she was like, well, see, I would, but I still have mixed emotions for Eric.
What the fuck? Stop playing.
When I tell y'all, that shattered my heart. Cause I just need some love. I just need some. That's what she said in that song. What if she said something like that? I don't know. She says, I need to start getting curved. I need to stop getting curved. She says something like that. I don't know. But yeah. So anyways, yeah, she said that, and I was like, it's either yes or no. And she was like, I need some time to think about it. And I was like, alright, dude. So fast forward about a good 5 days later, she was like, hey, Dwayne. She was like, hey, Dwayne. I was like, what's up? She was like, well, I would date you, but me and Eric just got back together. And I was like, okay, yeah, that's cool. Yeah, I'm happy for y'all, you know, real happy. Yeah. Yeah. But yeah, so her and Eric got back together, and there I was, once a lonely sixth grader looking for not to be curved once again. But you know, I moved on. It's 2019 now. Your boy, big eighth grader, out here living life happily, you know. You know, if you ain't seen my last video, you know, you should go watch that, you know. Anyways, let me stop. So, you want to know the crazy part of all about this, though? Is that during this time, Shalonda, she was getting a little touchy. I used to be walking in the hallway. She'd be like, poke me and freaking push me. And I'm like, what is your issue? Like, she really wanted me, but no, she had mixed emotions. So, yeah. But moral of the story is, if a girl and her boyfriend are off and on, 9 times out of 10, in a middle school relationship, they getting back together. So don't even worry about it. Don't waste your time. I'm just being honest with you. And it's only middle school. It's okay. In sixth grade and at 11 years old. Yeah. So yeah. But what did my Susie say? He said, I ain't nobody playing B. Either you choose me or you lose me. And simple as that, you know. Either you choose me or you lose me, you know. Ain't no if, ands, or buts. That's just that. So yeah, that's part two of how I got curved. And the next time you hear curved is how I curved the person for 3 years straight. Yeah. Curved the person three years straight, and also curved to somebody. Yeah. Anyways, like I said, that's for another story time. But I got some more, you know, I got some more good quality content coming out soon. So hope you guys really enjoyed this video. If you did, please leave a comment, share, like, don't dislike, don't do that. Share with your dog friends, your mama, your dad, your uncle, auntie, brother, sister, cousin, fish, goldfish, your teacher, turtle, the zoo, the neighbor. I don't know. Share it with anybody, cause you know, I'm out here trying to change people's lives. You know, like I'm really out here 13 trying to change people's lives, bro. Like real talk, you know. Like I just want to make people happy. I'm gonna make the world a better place. That's all I want to do. You know. In order to do that, I gotta build my platform up. And in order to do that, y'all gotta help me. And the same way y'all help me, I've come out with more. Even if I don't get as much help, I'm still going to be coming out with the same exact stuff I do now. Simple as that. Ain't no change in my game. Real talk. But as soon as As soon as I can start, you know, acquiring currency, I will gladly start being able to produce way more better content. But hey, the content I'm making now, y'all loving it. Like, everybody loves it now. So hey, I'm not even tripping, you know. But yeah, like I said, if you guys really enjoyed this video, leave a like, comment, share, subscribe, do all that good stuff. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Peace. It's me, boy, Double D, a.k.a. Camry, K-1, K-M-G, A.K. Wayne. I don't know. What's my name? Whatever you want to call me. And I'm out there, jump.